Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to another edition of Hill Face Radio. This is episode 46, and I am your host, Jeff Serta. Today we have a very special edition of the show. We're previewing the next Wrestle Circus Battle at the Big Top. And today joining me on this episode, we have Beau Jeremy. What's up?
Hello. Bo?
Joseph Montana.
What's up, guys?
Who's actually, it's your birthday today still, Joe.
I know it is my birthday today, but
I know when this goes up, it won't be your birthday anymore, but today is your birthday, so shout out, happy birthday. Hopefully you had a good day. I know you said you worked today, so hopefully it wasn't too bad of a day at work.
I'm about to talk wrestling. Makes my day a whole lot better.
Yeah, and then the special guest tonight is Eric B., who people might recognize the name from all of the awesome Wrestle Circus graphics that you see out on the internet. So welcome, Eric.
What's happening, guys?
All right, now I wanted to start talk with you to start this podcast out, Eric, and just talk a little bit about, first I wanted to ask you, how long have you been watching wrestling?
I'm 22 right now. I think I've watched wrestling since I was like literally 2 years old, because my dad, my grandpa, everyone was a wrestling fan, so I kind of was born into it.
Okay, and then, so obviously you started with WWF, or it was WWF at the time, I'm assuming?
WWF, like my dad had these old Dusty Rhodes like VHSs and stuff like that and DVDs, so we used to watch that like every day as kids too, so I used to watch the old stuff as well.
Who were some of your favorites growing up?
Shawn Michaels is my all-time favorite, above anyone else. So
Oh nice. So then you start, obviously you've basically been pretty much watching wrestling your whole entire life. Have you always pretty much also kept an eye? I know you said you were watching like the Dusty Rhodes stuff back then. That's pretty much like modern day independent wrestling. Have you always just kept an eye out on other independent wrestling, or was it just you just kind of watch whatever your dad kind of put on?
No. When I was a kid, I was like I'm still addicted to it. Like I'll watch anything, like anything wrestling wise. So anything indies, like I'm pretty familiar with that, like most indies in the world right now, even as a kid. So up until now, I still follow indies.
All right, and I'm sure everyone wants to know like how you got involved with doing the graphics for Wrestle Circus, and obviously you're getting a lot of great feedback. You're killing it in the graphic game right now, and how did you get involved with them?
Well, it's kind of weird. It's not like a glamorous story. It's just Al, he made like a post before Wrestle Circus even came out, like on Reddit, saying, "Yo, I'm starting a new company, I'm doing this and that." And I just asked him, I was like, "Hey, man, do you need any graphic work? And I'll do it for free," because I was really desperate. I was really bad at the time. I sent so many portfolios, and everyone said I was too, like, bad to do it. Like, I'm not going to say the companies, but they said I wasn't good enough to, do the graphics. So I just did them with Al, and I did them for free, and that's how it all started. And then he eventually started paying me and this and that.
Yeah, and I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but he flew you out to the first show, right?
Yeah, dude, that was, because I started off free, and he was so grateful that he just randomly, I just checked my email one day, and he's like, it was plane tickets, and I was so excited, and, I was so grateful for that. I guess he was grateful, too, for me just reaching out to him when he started, so.
Yeah, and in addition, I know you made the Sammy Guevara show graphic for us, but are you doing any other work, maybe not wrestling-related, just with any other companies?
The other stuff I do is pretty boring, like doing stuff for like dentist websites and this and that. I don't do much for wrestling companies, to be honest.
Okay. And then really quick before we get started, in case anybody doesn't know where to find you on Twitter, where can they find you?
It's ebags underscore New York NY. So it's EBHAGZ underscore NY.
All right. And can we expect you at any other Wrestle Circus shows possibly?
Possibly. I mean, I told Al, he offered a few times, but I was like, you know what, if it's if it's going to happen, I'm going to fly myself out. I appreciate everything he's done for me, so I'm going to figure my own way to get down there.
All right. And like I said, I just wanted to do like a little quick intro just so people can get a little bit more background on you and who you are. Obviously, you're more than just a graphics guy. You know, you said you've been watching wrestling your entire life. And now people know that Shawn Michaels is your all-time favorite. So, So now we'll go ahead and bring Beau and Jeremy back in. And
Beau and Jeremy.
It's Beau Jeremy. My bad. Hey, people mess up. Joseph.
Do it a lot, Jeff. Do it a lot.
All right, but the first match that we want to talk about is the hardcore match that features Jordan Lennox versus the trash man, George Gatton. And Joseph, I'll start with you on this match.
You know, it's about time that Jordan gets some retribution here, because it feels like every time we talk about a Jordan Lennox match, we're talking about some short little guy with a garbage can walking to the ring with his little safety vest on and interfering in these matches. And you know, in a hardcore match, what better way to take your aggression out on the person who's basically cost you a title numerous times than with the good old trash can to the skull? I think Jordan's going to come into this match with a lot of fire, a lot of anger, and I would hate to be the trash man on the receiving end of this beating.
So you think Jordan's going to walk away with the win on this one?
I think Jordan's going to potentially get arrested for attempted murder in this match.
I don't know, man. It is a hardcore match, so it'll be interesting to see what all gets brought out into this match, because, you know, typical hardcore matches, anything goes, you know. So I'm curious to see what kind of weapons are going to be brought. Obviously a trash can is going to be there, I would assume, but curious to see what else is going to be there. What are your thoughts on this match, Bo?
Yeah, this is going to be different than any other match we've seen at Wrestle Circus to this point. You know, obviously the first ever hardcore match in the tent, and these two guys, they seem to have a bit of a history out on the East Coast. Of course, we know the Trash Man has worked in CZW, and I believe him and Lennox have crossed paths a couple times before, and they have a style that they're familiar with that I think they're going to bring to the circus, that it's going to be quite interesting and fun to watch for us.
Yeah, for sure. And Eric, I know you've seen a lot of Wrestle Circus matches, and obviously you just mentioned you still keep up with indies and stuff, and any thoughts on this match and who you think is going to win?
I think Jordan Lennox is going to whoop his ass for sure, because am I allowed to say that?
Yeah, man, you can say it.
Oh, yeah. So, I mean, because I think there's an underlying storyline. Isn't there something with the trash man was talking trash about the Lennart family?
Yes,
so I think
was.
There's a lot of anger. I think he's going to take all that anger out when he finally gets his hands on him.
Yeah, I think he said he wanted to pile drive Lexi on the ground, if I'm not mistaken. I know he said he wanted to do something.
Like,
I don't know if it was a pile driver, but I know he said he wanted to do something to Lexi. But I'm sure, you know, obviously Al wasn't appreciative of those words. And, you know, Jordan, that's his sister-in-law, so I'm sure he wants to get a little bit of revenge for that. But, Bo, and I'm sorry I forgot to ask you who you thought was going to win this match. Are you going to make it a clean slate?
Oh, yeah, that little troll trash man is going down.
So everyone is in agreement that trash man is going down. So I don't know. We'll have to see what happens. It's going to be interesting to see, because like Joe mentioned, it's been brewing for a while. He's been sticking his nose in Jordan's business for months now, and Jordan's been waiting to get some revenge. So I don't know if this match is going to be the first. I'm just going in order the way they listed them on their graphic. I don't know if that's going to be the first match or not, but if it is, that's going to be one hell of a way to start the show for sure.
You know, and I was going to say, I've followed it on Reddit a little bit. The last couple of Wrestle Circus shows, they had a little thread on Reddit talking about it. And some of the fans that have watched the IPVV have been saying that they don't understand why this little troll, as Bo says, shows up in the ring and costs Jordan these matches. So I really hope that, you know, on the IPVV coming up, that they actually address why this is a thing, like why this match is going to be what it is and why the crowd's going to be the way they are, because, you know, the crowd's going to be hot for this match.
Oh, yeah, for sure. That's what I was saying. If that starts out the show, that's going to be one hell of a way to start the show. So,
that is true.
So, yeah, hopefully they can get the backstory and everyone's up to date before this match happens. But nonetheless, it's going to be a great match. And like I said, hopefully it starts to show that it'll be one way to get the crowd going. And the next match that's listed here is the Intergender Tag Match, who someone who we're pretty familiar with, ACH, is teaming with Christy Janes, and they are taking on Colt Cabana and Delilah Doom, who we are going to see on May 13th in Austin, Texas, defending her Sabotage title, assuming that she makes it past high-end this Saturday at VIP. But, Bo, we'll start with you on this mixed tag match.
Well, I like this match because it's a great way to feature some of the local wrestlers here, Christy Janes and Delilah Doom. Pairing them with ACH and Colt Cabana is a great way to get some eyes on them that probably would not normally check out their match. So I commend Wrestle Circus for some great booking on this one. ACH and Colt Cabana are two of the most entertaining wrestlers out there. Great veterans. They obviously have a lot to offer. And I think this match will just be a lot of fun. Don't you guys agree?
Yeah, for sure. I'm curious. I want to see how it's going to work out because obviously these two have never teamed before, to my knowledge. I think maybe Colt and Delilah have elsewhere, but I'm not 100% sure on that. But I know ACH and Christy have not tagged before, so curious to see how the chemistry is going to be on that night.
Delilah's already calling them Boom and Doom on Twitter. I think this is going to be like Bo said, you got two great veterans in Colt Cabana, ACH, who always put on quality matches. You know, ACH brings his style, which his love of comic books and anime really pairs well with Christy Janes and her whole, I guess you call it, geek superhero heroine type gimmick. But you got Christy Janes coming back from stardom. You know, she's hot. She had some momentum going. Delilah Doom, right now in Texas, she is on an upswing. I know she's been around for some time, but she's on an upswing right now. She's really starting to gain that hype behind her. There's a lot of Doomies that are coming on board now with her. She's got gold on her shoulder. What title is that? What's the name of it, Jeff?
Sabotage Wrestling.
Yeah. Sabotage.
Hey, but she also has the VIP XX division title. Inspire. I said she'll be at a VIP Saturday. But she has the Inspire XX division, and she also is one half of the Twin Dragons tag team champions, also at Inspire. So she's carrying a lot of gold these days.
She's carrying it. She's been putting in work in the gym. She's on, like I said, she's on a huge momentum swing here. And this match, I think, is going to be a great, fun intergender tag match. If it sticks to the usual rules of, you know, guys can wrestle girls, it's going to be fun to see ACH and Delilah go at it. Because I just think they'd have great chemistry in the ring. They seem like a pair that would really, really face off well against each other. Yeah. But like Bo said, it's going to be tons of fun. It's a huge, huge feature for these up-and-coming Texas guys.
Yeah, for sure. And even if they decided to start with this match, I wouldn't complain. Any of the matches, really. But, I mean, you know, there's certain ones that you're like, okay, I could see them starting with this, and it'd be a great way to get the crowd going and get them involved in the show. What are your thoughts on this match, Eric?
I agree with everyone. I don't really have a favorite as far as it goes because I like all four of them. And I think it's just going to be a fun match. You know, the crowd's just going to be into it. There's going to be a lot of, you know, maybe comedy spots with Colt Cabana. So I'm just going to be very excited to watch it.
Yeah, for sure. And I think, like you just mentioned, everyone agrees it's going to be fun. Comedy is going to be there. Obviously, the wrestling is going to be there. Everyone in the match can wrestle. So it'd be good to see. Joe, what's your pick for this match?
I got to stay with my Doomy. I got to go with Delilah and Colt. Boom and Doom, going to bring it.
Bo?
That's good. You could flip a coin in this one. I'll just go with ACH and Christy Janes in this one.
Did you really flip a coin, though?
I could. No, I didn't. But I'll go with it. I'll side with ACH on this one.
All right, Eric, you're going to be the tiebreaker on this one. Who are you going to go with?
I'm just going to go with Colt and Delilah just because the whole Boom and Doom connection, they're going to want to get that going. So maybe that's going to happen.
Yeah, so we'll see. We'll see what happens. So as far as the picks on this show, I guess Boom and Doom are winning. Now we move on to the tag team triple threat match, which features the number one contenders for the tag team titles, Extra Talented, Aaron Solo and Ricky Starks, taking on Monkey Flip, which is Space Monkey and Flip Gordon, versus the Boys. And the Boys are obviously a mainstay with WrestleCircus ever since they've been there. Going to be a lot of crazy action in this match. Eric, we'll start with your thoughts on this match.
I just think it's going to be insanity just looking at the teams, just like, you know, all the crazy things that are going to happen. As far as who I want to win, extra talented all the way. No matter what, I'm always rooting for those guys. I'm a huge fan of them.
Yeah, and they're also just featured on Beau and Rogelio's show, Let's Talk About Wrestling. If you haven't had a chance to watch that, go to our YouTube channel. It's on there. Really great show. I thought I was watching the Food Network for a second. I'm not going to lie. I was like, what is this show? Is put together very well. So really cool show. But yeah, so Joe, what are your thoughts on this match?
You know, you can give me extra talented and give me the Boys. I'd say it's going to be a great, great match. You throw in Monkey Flip and that match just rises up a couple more levels. But, you know, I think we're disrespecting someone here, Jeff. I believe you did not address the elephant in the room. You did not call them what they are. You forgot to address extra talented as your Sabotage tag team champions.
Well,
because I believe they are carrying the gold on their belt.
They are
around their rather shoulders. So, I mean, I'm just saying, you need to throw that respect out there. Put a little respect on it.
You are right. They do have possession of the belt and belts. And Aaron Solo did say the law is 9/10 of the law is possession.
Possession, 9/10 of the law.
Yeah. So, but even with all of that said, they did not rightfully win those titles. They stole them. So they will have the opportunity, though. They'll May 13th, they'll get an opportunity to be crowned the rightful champion. So we'll see what happens. But, yeah, so who are you going with in this match?
I'm staying with my tag team champions, extra talented.
So you're still already – you're already calling them the tag champs then?
How can you not call them – you know.
They didn't win. You know. They didn't win a match.
But Jeff, come on.
All right.
Come on.
Bo?
Well, whether they're rightful champions or not, one thing we do know and can't be argued is that they are the number one contenders for the big top tag team titles in Wrestle Circus. And as far as this match goes, I think it's just like the last one. It's going to be a lot of fun. You got a lot of fan favorites in this match. The Boys are Wrestle Circus favorites. Space Monkey is definitely popular. Everyone's going to have dozens of bananas. I'm expecting to see that. Flip Gordon, I think I'm unfamiliar with him, but with a name like Flip Gordon, you expect to see a lot of excitement. But I'm picking extra talented in this match. They're our Boys, and I think they'll take care of business in this match.
Yeah, so clean sweep for them in this match. And I got a chance to see Flip Gordon WrestleMania weekend at a couple shows, and that dude is insane. So yeah, it's going to be nuts in this match. I expect chaos all over the whole building because, you know, matches typically spill out of the ring, and this is going to be one of them that I think is going to spill out. So we'll see if Extra Talented can walk away with the win there. But the next match we have is Dirty Andy Dalton taking on Mr. 450 and Scorpio Sky for the Sideshow Championship number one contender. But if you recall, Andy Dalton and Mr. 450 are already number one contenders for this title. So I'm not sure if that is being put on the line, and then, you know, whoever walks away from this match, now they are the sole number one contender, or if they still will get their shot. But nonetheless, this is for a shot at the Sideshow Championship. Bo, we'll start with you and your thoughts on this match.
Yeah, I think this is I like this match because you're taking all the guys who basically kind of have a rightful claim at that Sideshow title and put them all in a match and just say, all right, let's see who's the best and we'll get that shot. You know, Dirty Dalton won his opportunity at South by South Wrestle Circus. Mr. 450 won his opportunity. Geez, it was way back in November before his injury. And so he's finally returning to the circus. And I guess I don't know if the injury negates his claim, but I don't know how that works. But he's getting another shot. Scorpio Sky, of course, you know, he still feels bitter about the way he lost the title under those 24/7 circumstances. So he's always going to feel like he should be the champion. So I think he's going to be bitter just the fact that he has to wrestle another match to get to that title again. But I like this match because all three guys have a claim and they're all great talent. So we're going to settle it here at the tent on Sunday.
Yeah, for sure. And your thoughts on this match, Eric?
Scorpio Sky is the Charlotte Flair of Wrestle Circus. No matter what the title is always going to come back to him, I feel. So I think that's it's a pretty safe bet that he's going to win and he's going to get that title back eventually.
Yeah, and he was the longest reigning Sideshow champion. So I know the company's still very young, but, you know, regardless of the fact, he still retained against a lot of different odds and ended up being the longest reigning champ. So it'll be interesting to see if he can get another shot at that title again. Joseph, your thoughts on this match?
The Charlotte Flair of Wrestle Circus. I like that. I like that a lot. You know, you go on and on about Scorpio Sky, and we had this last time we did predictions. We had the same point. I don't want to make it again, but I'll say it again. Yes, he was the longest reigning Sideshow champ. That reign is very, very, very tainted. I don't care how you say that he overcame all these odds. He won two times against Jordan Lennox when he should have lost. The opponent of your George Gatan coming in, trash man, and ruining that for Jordan. So, honestly, I don't see why Scorpio's in this match. If you're going to have a legit claim to the number one contendership, you put Eddie Dalton and Mr. 450 against each other and say, you know what, Mr. 450, you were injured. You got to regain your throne. Andy, you won last time, so you get your shots. Let's see who's going to actually get it. Scorpio's just a throwaway in this match. And you know what? Unfortunately, he's probably going to win it because Charlotte Flair.
Dirtiest player in the game. But also remember 450, and this is going to tie into something later on in the predictions, but he was put out of action by Sammy Guevara when we were in Arlington. He attacked him with a chair, and yeah, 450's knee was already injured, but Sammy made sure that he was on the shelf for months by attacking him with the chair. So I bring that up now so I can bring it up later, but just think about that when we talk about Sammy Guevara. But prediction time, I know Eric already said he's going with Scorpio, and you said you're going with Scorpio too, right, Joe?
Yes.
And Bo?
I'm going to go with Mr. 450. I think he's had a lot to overcome to get back here, and it's a night of redemption for him to come back and get this victory.
Yeah, so let's see how that one plays out as well. But the next one is the Circus Instant Classic match, Jervis Cottonbelly versus Kiku Toro. And Kiku Toro is someone who we saw at Inspire a couple of months ago. Does a little bit of the comedy stuff too, really funny, really good wrestler. Does a really good spot to me, but what should we expect from this match?
Shenanigans. Just shenanigans. That word will cover the entire match right there. Shenanigans. I think it's going to be a really fun match, and the crowd's going to enjoy the heck out of this match. Like you said, it's going to be comedy spots. It's going to be wrestling. It's going to all tie together in a great, great package. And I when I saw this match, I was actually thinking about getting the IPVV, since I can't be there, to actually watch this match. I think this is going to be a great, great match.
Yeah, for sure. What are your thoughts on this match, Bo?
I know what we're not going to see. It's not going to be a high-flying clinic or a five-star technical matchup, but if you don't have a smile on your face during this match, you probably don't have a soul. Cottonbelly is probably the biggest fan favorite at Wrestle Circus, and Kiku Toro, for those who know about him, they absolutely—I love him. You know, he brings that comedy from Japan. I think he just moved to the States a few months ago, and he's making his rounds and bringing his style to the American Indies, and I definitely look forward to this match. It's going to be a lot of fun. Do I want to give a prediction already? I'd go with Cottonbelly just because he knows the ropes around here.
Yeah. Anything else you'd like to add, Eric?
Pretty much everyone else did. Wrestle Circus doesn't take – they make these, like, you know – I guess Jervis Cottonbelly is, like, you know, one of the most popular guys here. And I feel like this match just end up outside. They can just chase each other and just do anything. So I have no idea what to expect between them. I think it's just going to be a fun, happy match.
And then remember, from the very first Wrestle Circus, Jervis still has that match going on with Dick Justice. So I don't. Oh, yeah. He's not advertised, but he can. He showed up before. When he wasn't advertised, but I guess he saved Jervis that one time when he showed up unannounced. But regardless, that match is still going on. We could possibly see Dick Justice come in and try to close out that match. Who knows? But that'll just tie into what I think the word Joe said was shenanigans. That will just add even more shenanigans to this match. But so Beau's going Cotton Belly. Joe, did you say who you're going with?
Oh, I go Cotton Belly too.
Eric?
Cotton Belly.
Clean sweep for Mr. Cotton Belly, so I'm sure he will be happy to hear that if he listens to this podcast. But next match that we're going to talk about is a intergender singles match. All Ego Ethan Page is taking
favorite wrestler
is taking on Candice LeRae. Bo, I guess we'll start with you since you and Mr. Ego have a little bit of history there.
You're going to make me talk about Ethan Page. I bet he'd love that, wouldn't he? Mr. All Ego. I'd rather talk about Candice LeRae, let's face it. Come on. She could contend for the Ringmaster title. That's how much I believe in her. She's fantastic. I hope Ethan Page gets his ass kicked. And there, I'm going to move on. Go ahead, take it from here.
Bo, not holding back any words there. Eric, I guess we'll toss it on over to you to give your thoughts on this match.
No, I agree with Bo. Ethan is probably one of the most hateable, in a good way, I guess. But he's so hateable. Like, I don't know if you guys saw that video of him, how to cut a promo. It's like one of the most hateable videos ever. I think Candice is going to destroy him in her own way. She's gonna find a way to beat him up. And I think she's going to win.
All right, so two for Candice. Joe, are you going to make it a clean sweep? But talk about what do you think is going to happen in this match before you give your prediction.
What I think is going to happen in this match, I think people are going to hate Ethan. Candice is going to come in, kick him square in the face, get a 1-2-3, and there's your match right there.
Wow. So it's going to be a squash match, you're predicting.
Not a squash match per se, but it's going to be a Candice LeRae match. You know, I don't think – I'm just – I just want to see Beau rush the ring.
I just want to see. I think we need to have a camera on Beau for the entire match just to get his reactions.
Beau, if you don't mind me asking, what is the issue between you and Ethan?
Yeah, Beau, what's the issue for everyone that doesn't know?
I'm sorry, I'm not even at the.
I just think he's annoying. I mean, any guy who's going to walk around and call himself All Ego, I mean, how full of yourself do you have to be? I mean, really. So that's that.
And Beau doesn't hold back on Twitter. Like, Ethan knows Beau doesn't like him. It's great.
Well, Beau, didn't y'all go at it at Evolve too?
No, a little bit. Yeah, you called him over for an interview, and I kind of groaned in disgust, and he may have uttered an expletive at me.
He did. So Beau doesn't only say it on Twitter. He tells him to his face, and they've gone back and forth before on Twitter and in real life. So there's no love lost there.
I'll be front row and be sure to give them an earful at Wrestle Circus.
I'm sure that you will. And we need a camera on you. I'm going to see if we can work that out to record your reactions during this entire match. Or maybe
entire
you should just
match.
Maybe you should just do like a Facebook Live or something from your phone. But that'll be interesting to see. So obviously everyone's going Candice LeRae in this because there's no love for Mr. Page.
Can we just say congratulations to Candice on debuting on NXT?
Yeah, for sure.
Shout out, that's awesome for her.
Yeah, for sure. So congrats to her. And then also, the women's tournament they announced. I don't know if they haven't announced any participants yet, but it'd be interesting to see who they use from the indies for that. So
yeah, that'd be interesting to see who they pull in.
Yeah, so once they – obviously we'll have to keep that for a separate podcast, but once they announce that, we'll have to get something going for that. But the next match is a Fatal 4-Way that's going to feature Mr. Ray Rowe, Davey Boy Smith Jr., Jax Dane, who we were just talking about, friend of the show, and Moose. Eric, we'll start with you in this Fatal 4-Way that's going to feature some massive men, and it's going to be basically like a war in that match.
This is going to be, I don't even know what to expect as far as just going to be four monsters just going crazy. I actually think that I want to see Davey Boy Smith Jr. win. Just so he could, like, point over to Lance Hoyt on commentary and be like, that's for you, buddy, or something like that. Because I know he's supposed to have that, like, hardcore match, but it got canceled or something.
Yeah. So it'd be cool. Like you said, that'll be a cool little tribute to Lance. I know Lance is sidelined right now, recovering from a back injury. So we wish him a speedy recovery and hope to see him back in the ring soon. But, Joe, your thoughts on this Fatal 4-Way?
Yeah, we wish Lance a speedy recovery. The tables don't wish Lance a speedy recovery.
Especially our table.
Bunch of monsters. This, I mean, you could even call this, you know, a monster's ball. Don't sue me, TNA. this match is going to just be hard hitting. You know, Ray Rogue doesn't hold back. Jack Stain, Godzilla in the ring. Moose, who I haven't seen, you know, in action except just in spurts on, you know, on TNA or not on TNA, but, you know, in the indies. So we really like to see these guys go out. Dave Lewis Smith, who's impressed me more and more each time I've seen him in the ring. I think this, like you say, it's going to be a brutal war. It's going to be heavy hitting. Nothing but power. And God help those that get in the way.
Yeah. So, Beau, you might want to take a step back away from your front row seat in this match because action may spill outside and it could, you know, fall into your seated area. So be careful out there. I'll say that. But your thoughts on this match?
Yeah, these are not the men you want running into you. This is the Hoss fight of the evening, and you got some of the best in the game in Ray Rowe, Davey Boy, Jack Stain, and Moose, all making huge waves. Of course, Jack Stain debuting on TNA here, and Moose still the grand champion in Impact Wrestling. Man, this is going to be a good one, and I think the only way any one of these guys loses is when you put them in the ring with the other three guys. So, it's a hard one to pick. I'm going to go with Jack Stain just because he's our Texas guy, and he's been on a roll recently. So I'm going to go with Jack Stain in this four-way.
Yeah, not a bad – any pick that you make in this match is not a bad choice, but Jax is obviously a solid choice. Joseph, who are you going to roll with in this match?
You know, we should have had Rudy on here because he could have told us what it feels like to get in the way of one of these men because I just – I was editing that VIP footage and seeing the moment that Rudy gets squished between Ray Rowe and a cage.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny.
He was telling me that he was kind of disappointed that you didn't, or actually, I'm sorry, he said he was happy that you didn't include it in the highlight video.
It wouldn't have made sense because all you see is Ray Rowe, and all you see is like Ray Rowe's back, and you're here. And it
goes off. Oh man! So for people that don't know what we're talking about, we covered a VIP show a while back. I think it was January, February, and Rudy was ringside, and there was a cage match that spilled outside of the ring. I believe it was Ray Rowe and Keith Lee, right, Joseph?
Yes.
That were right next to Rudy. And then next thing you know, Rudy gets smashed against the cage in between those two guys, and he was injured that night. But it was good for us because, I mean, he got really good footage of it, but bad for Rudy.
I had to post a GIF of that later.
Yes, please do that. But yeah, you're picking this match.
Oh, right. I'll go Ray Rowe.
Ray Rowe. All right, Eric, did you make a pick?
Yeah, Davey Boy Smith Jr.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You said you wanted him to win for Lance Hoyt. That is correct. So three different men that you guys picking in this match. So we'll see how it all plays out on Sunday. Next match is a championship match. It is for the Lady of the Ring Championship. Defending champion Rachel Ellering takes on Taya, who we see a lot of on Lucha Underground. And she was obviously the Reina de Rain champion from Mexico. Or she was. She's not anymore, but she had that title for a while. What can we expect in this match, Eric?
I know Taya is from Lucha Underground, but I'm not too familiar with her in-ring work. But as far as Rachel Ellering, I don't know if you guys remember, that last match with her and Tessa Blanchard was amazing.
Yes.
So, I mean, if she brings that again, I mean, I think this might be match of the night. So, you know, I think Rachel's going to win, by the way. She's amazing.
Rachel's going to retain, according to Eric. Joseph, your thoughts on this match?
You know, it seems like every Wrestle Circus show we've had, the women have just brought it. And, you know, credit that to every competitor that stepped in the ring for that Lady of the Ring Championship. But Rachel has just managed to somehow soar above them all. And like Eric just said, last match against Tessa blew the roof off that building. I mean, this is a venue in Austin that takes rock concerts. I don't think it was prepared for the level of excitement that match brought. Completely. Taya, you know, she's great in the ring. La Huera Loca from Lucha Underground. She's got a nice style, you know, a bit more power than Rachel usually is. But I think Rachel retains. Is there a better women's champion at the moment besides Delilah for WrestleCircus than Rachel?
Yeah, Yeah, I don't know. It's going to be tough, man. As you guys just mentioned, she, and not only in that match, in other matches that we've seen her at Wrestle Circus, and obviously not just at Wrestle Circus as well, but just in general, she's a great competitor. It's going to be tough to beat. Whoever, if anyone ever beats her, you know, they're going to have to be like on their A-plus game to walk away with that title. So it'll be interesting to see how this one plays out. And Taya has obviously won gold before. She's not a pushover, so to be, I know, like, I can see this match being match of the night. Like Eric said, it's going to be crazy. Just looking forward to it a lot. Bo, your thoughts on this match?
I got a couple things on this one. You guys already talked about how great Rachel Ellering is, so I don't feel I need to go there. We all agree with that. A special point I think we haven't mentioned yet is her old trainer, Mr. Lance Storm, yes, is going to be in attendance in the building this Sunday. So you wonder how much extra motivation that's going to give to her in this match. Maybe he'll be ringside. Who knows? So I think that's a big deal. You know, I'd be real excited to have my trainer there, you know, come all the way from Canada to watch her defend her title. And Rachel Ellering's just making waves all over the wrestling scene. I'm afraid we're going to lose her one day, but while she's here and she's a champion, she's a great one, and we're happy to have her. Yeah. About her opponent, though, I got a special I got to make a note. Let's see. It's not really a known secret that her and Mr. John Morrison are an item. Right. They both happen to be going for Wrestle Circus gold this Sunday. That's John true. Morrison, I believe he has all the gold in AAA, if I'm not mistaken. There's a chance that Taya and Morrison walk away from Wrestle Circus on Sunday as the ringmaster and the lady of the ring. I just want to paint that picture in your head. It's definitely a possibility. And you know what? I'm just going to go out on a limb and go ahead and pick Taya in this match. I think she could surprise some people and take the title from Rachel.
Wow. That's a bold prediction. Bro. Yeah. So, Joe, you said you are going Rachel, right?
Yes.
So two for Rachel, one for Taya. Bo going with the bold prediction. So we'll see what happens again. But the next match we have involves someone who is a really good friend of the show, obviously, because he has his own show on our website, Mr. Money's Worth, the best ever, talking about Sammy Guevara, who's taking on Matt Sydal. Bo, we'll go right back to you and start with your thoughts on this match.
Well, the pick is easy. I think you guys already know. You know, Matt Sydal, banned in Japan. He's a great veteran. We've seen him everywhere. Of course, WWE, Ring of Honor, TNA. I think he's back with TNA now, as a matter of fact. And Sammy just adds another great name to his list. Another guy he can learn from, another guy to work with, and another guy he'll beat because he's the best ever.
All right. Going with the best ever, Sammy Guevara. Joe, your thoughts on this match?
You know, Sammy just brings it every match. And Matt Sydal, I've seen him bring it every match he's brought it. I think this is going to be a high-flying, action-packed, any other adjective that goes along with those other two. Sammy is Mr. Wrestle Circus. You will not give Sammy a match and Sammy not blow the roof off, the doors off the building, the roof off the building, the windows out, you know, blow your mind with what he does in the ring. I think this match is going to be super, super fun. You know, I hate to do it because I love me some Sammy Guevara. But, you know, I thought he was going to beat John Morrison, and that didn't happen, which I think was wrong. But still, that didn't happen. And, you know, I kind of see Matt Sydal, formerly known as Aaron Bourne, or right? Aaron Bourne was his name?
Evan
Bourne, see? I think he takes it out. I think he pulls off a nice shooting star press, and he gets the 1-2-3.
So you're going with the guy who you don't even remember his name.
Yeah, I remember who he is. Evan, Aaron, Jason Bourne, whatever. It's Bourne.
See, that's karma. That's karma coming back for you when I said Bo Jeremy instead of Bo and Joe.
Yeah, okay. That was
worse. All right, so you're going Sydal, or what'd you call him? You didn't call him Evan. You called him something else, Bourne.
Called Aaron Bourne.
Aaron Bourne is what you're...
Aaron Boone with the Yankees in baseball, Jason Bourne, Evan. It's all...
Boone the Bounty Hunter.
It's a mess in my head right now.
Yeah. All right, Eric, what would you like to add for this match?
I was just going to say that every month they pretty much send like a dream match Sammy Guevara's way. I'm sure he's like notching off on his wish list because, you know, what was it? John Morrison, Shane Strickland, Ricochet, and now Matt Sydal. Unfortunately, I think Matt Sydal is going to win because as much as I love Sammy Guevara, and he's actually my favorite all time as far as Wrestle Circus. He's my favorite right now. But I liken him to Shawn Michaels. He's going to put on the most important match of the night, but he might not win. And he's going to stick a middle finger at the end. So I think the fans are going to win at the end.
I hope that Sammy does not listen to this podcast.
I'm thinking the same thing. Sammy, I picked you, buddy, if you are listening. Just remember that. Both.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Sammy.
I did it for the ratings, Sammy. For the ratings.
Yeah, I wish I would have let him know that we're doing this tonight so I could have just called him right now and be like, hey, Eric and Joseph did not pick you, by the way. So anything you'd like to say to them? But yeah, so hopefully
well,
he does.
Well, fuck that guy. My name's Sammy. That's what we get.
He'd just hang up because he hangs up on everybody. So,
yeah.
But, yeah, so, Beau, you're outnumbered on this one. Mr. Money's worth walking away with a loss, according to Eric and Joseph. So,
they're both wrong. So,
well, Beau, we probably should get a camera on you for this match, too, since, you know, you are in contention.
No,
for...
just keep the cameras on Sammy.
You know what? Next time we get, you know, Sabotage LA, we're going to put Beau versus Jake. The battle of number one Sammy fans.
Jake doesn't want that problem.
Yeah. He's probably still recovering from that tour of the islands he got.
Probably.
God, that was brutal.
But yeah, so let's go ahead and keep this thing rolling. Six-man tag action is next. Sammy Callahan and the Crist brothers taking on Shane Strickland, Leo Rush, and Desmond Xavier. Eric, we'll start with you.
You know, just looking at this card, this could easily be the main event. And, like, I guess, like, four or five other matches could easily main event the show. But I think this one is the one that all, like, the mainstream, like, people are going to pick up just by this match happening. Because I think Sammy Callahan is just going crazy right now. You know, he owns his own company, and he's just been going crazy on the indies right now. I think that Sammy Callahan and the Crist brothers are going to win this one.
Oh, nice pick there. Beau, let's go with you.
Oh, I am drooling with anticipation. This match is going to be great. I think the fans are going to be hungry for it. The team of Strickland, Rush, and Xavier, for probably maybe the first time and possibly the last time ever, they've all entered. Well, actually, Leo Rush is making his debut, but they've all entertained the crowd before. So we know what they bring. It's going to be exciting. It's going to be high-flying. It's going to be fast-paced. The fans are definitely going to win. We may get a five or six star match out of this one. Who knows? You know, I'm excited for it. I'll pick Strickland, Rush, and Xavier to win. The dream team.
All right, Joe, heading over to you. Looks like you're going to have to be the tiebreaker here.
You know, you could have given me a triple threat match with Strickland, Rush, and Xavier. I would have been happy. You could have given me, you know, Sammy Callahan versus Shane Strickland. I would have been happy. But you throw in Dave and Jake and Chris, make it a six-man tag match, and oh my goodness. I mean, when they announced this match, Twitter went a little bit crazy. I mean, this is, like you said, it's a dream match. Almost every card they give us, one of these matches is just stands out. You think, man, I'm never going to see this again. And this is that match on this card. And like Eric said, easily four or five matches on this card could main event, but this one stands at the very, very top of the one that everybody's there to see. I mean, you probably have guys that would never have bought an iPay-per-view gonna buy it just for this match right here. I think it's gonna be a hell of a lot of fun. We saw what Shane Strickland with Killshot and what David and Desmond Xavier could do. You know, do a few Wrestle Circuses. I mean, that triple threat with Rey Fénix is still one of my top three matches of all time that I've seen ever. So I am just excited. I mean, the energy is building for this match, and I think it's just gonna be an amazing match and tons of fun to watch, and the spots are gonna be insane.
All right, who are you going with?
Oh, yeah, I got to pick that.
yep.
I got to go with Desmond Xavier, Shane Strickland, and Leo Rush. I think they're going to pull out that win. It's going to be fun regardless. Yeah, it's I was going to call Desmond something else, and then I thought about it, and I remembered that one. The Cardiac Kid, Shane Strickland, and Leo Rush. That's what I meant to say. There's my confidence.
All right, so we'll see. And of course, that takes us to our main event for the Wrestle Circus Ringmaster Championship. Current champion Brian Cage defending against John Morrison. Who you got, Bo?
Oh boy, this is going to be a great match. Of course, huge names. You know, earlier I painted that picture of Taya and Morrison walking out as dual champions. I'm not going to pick it, though, because earlier I said I'd never pick against Brian Cage, and I'm not going to do it here. He's a great champion, and I think he'll find a way to win. I think with Melissa Santos in his corner, he could negate anything Taya might, if Taya decides to get involved for some reason. It could never go there, but who knows. I'll go with Cage.
Cage. All right, Joe, who are you picking? Or what? First, your thoughts on the match, then who are you picking?
In order for Brian Cage to lose, there has to be a guy steps to the ring, that just wants it more. And, you know, right now, no one wants to hold that championship more than Brian Cage himself. I don't see John Morrison stepping into the plate and beating him. I think it's going to be, you know, not that John Morrison is a slacker or not capable of it. I just don't see the desire in him that I see in Brian Cage. Brian Cage is Wrestle Circus. I mean, there's no way around that. The guy has been stellar representing it, and no one on this roster deserves to hold that title more than Brian Cage right now. So, I mean, John Morrison is going to put up a fight, but Brian Cage is going to retain.
All right, Eric, and any other last words you want to add to this final match on the card and your prediction?
I think company-wise, Brian Cage is the poster boy for when you think Wrestle Circus, you think Brian Cage. He's on all the graphics. He's like the main, you know, attraction as far as being a champion. He's really proud to hold that title. So unfortunately for John Morrison, I think that Brian Cage is going to win and retain.
All right, clean sweep for Mr. Cage. John Morrison obviously getting the opportunity, like you guys mentioned, to after defeating Sammy Guevara. I did forget to bring this up during the Sammy part, though. The 450, Mr. 450. We see a lot of different things happen at Wrestle Circus. Obviously, Trashman gets involved with a lot of different things, but could 450 be coming out for revenge and cost Sammy Guevara this match at all? Do you think, is that a possibility that we could see? Anyone?
I think if it was a title match, yes. Because what greater way to get back at the guy who put you on the shelf than to cost him gold? I think with this just being a regular one-on-one, I don't see Mr. 450 spoiling it or using his run-in card on this one at all.
Yeah, just something to think about. I just wanted to throw that out there. All right, and that's all of the matches, gentlemen, that we've previewed for the upcoming show this Saturday. If you don't have tickets, you can go to WrestleCircus.com, get your tickets if you want to wait, which I don't advise you to do. But if you want to wait, I'm sure there might be tickets at the door. But like I said, I would advise you to go to WrestleCircus.com. And if you cannot make it to Texas, if you don't live in Texas, or if you live 4 or 5 hours away, don't want to make that drive, they do offer the iPay-per-view, same website, WrestleCircus.com. Any last words you'd like to add, Bo, before we end this podcast?
It'll be good to be home back at 800 Congress. It feels like it's been a while after a midnight after Mania excursion in Florida and the South by South Wrestle Circus at Emo's. It's going to be great to have everyone back at 800 Congress. The atmosphere should be electric. The card looks fantastic. It's such a great variety show. You've got the Hoss fights, the high flyers, the women, the comedy, everything. It'll be a great time. And if you have the opportunity, you should be there, 800 Congress this Sunday for Wrestle Circus.
Yeah. And of course, if you want to follow Bo on Twitter, you can find him at Final Bowser. That's Bowser, like the enemy, the bad guy on, or we'll call him the heel on Mario. Eric, any other last words you want to add to this before we close this thing out?
Pretty much just Wrestle Circus puts on, I think, the best indie shows every month. Just as when I watch the fans on the iPay-per-view, everyone's having the most fun. And, you know, these cards are stacked as hell. So there's always going to be something that you could find that you really, really like. So I'm very excited for this show.
Yep. And Joe, we'll pass it on over to you. Anything you want to add? And, of course, where they can find you on Twitter.
Yeah, Wrestle Circus, great shows, great fun. If you have not made it to a show and you live in the Austin area, I don't know what the hell you're waiting for. I mean, just get in the building. I mean, it's worth every penny. Every penny. Even the iPay-per-views worth every penny. Don't just wait to read about it or hear us talk about it. Get there. Get in the field. Get in the atmosphere. Be a circus freak. Come on.
And where can they find you on Twitter?
Find me on Twitter. I never say my Twitter handle. Joe underscore mountain underscore HF.
Yep.
That might change here in a few because I'm getting tired of typing the long thing.
Just put like JM or something. I don't know.
I think it's going to become the Joe Energy. But the Joe that's Energy. Tentative.
Huh? Yeah, you might as well just do it. You already said it. You might as well just do it.
Oh, damn it.
But yes, and I do also want to mention before we close this thing up that the show is dedicated to someone who we recently lost, Maggie Martinez. Very unfortunate situation. Tragically, like I said, we lost her. Show is dedicated to her, so that's really awesome of Al and the whole Wrestle Circus team to do that and dedicate this show to her. Really cool to see all of the support, and I know Rogelio mentioned it to me that it meant a lot to him and his family to get the support, not only from Wrestle Circus, but from just the wrestling community. Everyone kind of just came together and was, you know, sending prayers and positive thoughts to them, and I know he really appreciated it. He told me, I was talking to him the other day, he was just like, man, I was just... really, my family's really appreciative of everything they're doing. So that Wrestle Circus dedicating this show to her is just another thing that's really great to see. And kudos to them for doing that. So, and again, still shout out to the Martinez family and sorry for the loss. I know everyone will continue to pray for that family. And just wanted to mention that. Sorry to, I guess, end on a lower note, but it's kind of a positive note, you know, because they're dedicating the show in her memory and keeping that thing rolling. And I know Rogelio has some buttons, that he is selling in her memory. So if you have a chance, get a hold of Rogelio and you can get some of those cool buttons. They're like limited edition. I know Wrestle Circus has a pin in there. We also have a pin in there. And then there's one with Rogelio and Maggie. And then there's another.
There's a Sammy one too.
Sammy Guevara one. Yes, Sammy was kind enough to be a part of that as well. So shout out to everyone involved in that. And thank you, gentlemen, for joining me. And that will conclude this episode. And so we will see you guys next time.